Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today I'm talking to you about a common theme that came up in the new year. In the new year, a lot of clinics seek out training or advice, and our phones go busy because we train a lot of clinics in the run of a year. And clinics that want to improve their outcome for the new year, maybe want to learn a little bit more about fillers, about practice development, or in this case, patient satisfaction. So this year I've had a lot of inquiries. We want you to come down for training. We want to learn how to improve patient satisfaction and what am I seeing out there. So I thought I'd address it. And why is it in the aesthetic industry it seems like patient satisfaction or getting an excellent treatment and having a high percentage of patients happy with their treatments is a little difficult for some clinics to achieve, and really all of us continue to work on this aspect of our clinic, whether we're established practices or new. Well, there's a few reasons. First of all, the products we use, like anything in medicine, have an element of unpredictability. And in the aesthetic world, where people are paying, they don't really accept that unpredictability as they would more in the medical world. If you get an antibiotic, as for an example, to treat a bacterial infection, and it doesn't work the first time around, we might try a different antibiotic. However, in the aesthetic world, if we try a treatment to, say, address a line or a wrinkle or a fold or an acne scar, and it doesn't work and we go to the next stage, patients wonder why that is, and they're not as accepting of the failure of the first treatment. But you got to keep in mind, this is medicine. And while we can predict things or a collagen response of one person on an average basis, we can't predict every single patient 100%, which is why a lot of times, if you go to review sites, treatments get about an 80% rating, then that would be an excellent rating. A lot of treatments that we do commonly get a 60% rating. So that's one reason, unpredictability. A second reason is sometimes treating patients or clients, it's a bit of a moving target. What do I mean by that? Well, on given day, patient might want a subtle result. And so we give them a subtle result. And as they get used to that result, they wanted actually a more dramatic result. And so they might come back and say, well, I wanted a subtle result. I got 2 or 3 vials of filler, but I wanted something more dramatic. So people change their views of what they want as they see the results. Not only do their views of their aesthetics change, but maybe the financial situations change, where maybe they felt they shouldn't have spent that amount of money for an X result. And so that's another factor I think that clinics face, is it's a bit of a moving target. And the third comes to how we gives us insight in what we can do to actually make this a little bit better, and that is education. It's all in the consult, educating our patients. As an example of this, most people come in, or they'll call, the most common question we get asked is, how much is a single vial of filler? Now, when we get that, we know that the chance of an unsatisfied patient who asks that question goes up. Why? Because they're not educated about what one vial of filler is. They're not really looking for a vial of filler. They're looking for a result. And most people don't realize that 5 vials of filler is 1 teaspoon. So go into your counter cabinet and get a teaspoon and fill that up. And that's 5 vials. Then we're using that over the whole facial region to obtain an excellent result of rejuvenating a patient. So as you can see, it might take a few teaspoons to get the result that one wants. So really it's about education, it's about the consult, it's about developing a long-term relationship with your physician, your provider, so that if you need to switch gears during your treatment plan to something a little bit different, that you can do that based on the response you had. A lot of people ping-pong around to different clinics, and they get a treatment here, it's a little cheaper over here, then they go to another treatment clinic here because of a special, say. But it doesn't end up really being a special, because now there are products in their face or on their body that they don't even know what they are, and they're not working synergistically together. It's about mixing treatments and matching them to get the best result for an individual patient. So I hope that helps. Keep on this YouTube channel. or join us on Facebook for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.